applications of elastic behavior of materials. While constructing the buildings or bridges, we take the support of pillars. Suppose if the pillar is constructed with a round edges like this. Now if you want to construct with a pillar with a greater height, then it may be buckled due to the heavy load. To avoid this, what we do, we take the pillar in the shape of a cross-sectional shaped load bearing bar. This is cross-sectional shaped load bearing bar. It supports the more load and it cannot be buckled. Or the pillars which are constructed with bridges cannot be taken as round shaped bars, round shaped the pillars. These are constructed as a pillar with distributed ends. The pillars distributed with distributed ends, the pillars with distributed ends supports the more load as compared to the pillars with rounded ends. And here, in the construction of pillars, we use the steel. Why we are using the steel here? Because steel is more elastic compared to all other materials here, and it is cheaper compared to steel. Some other metals also there which are more elastic. Here the elasticity of a material is depend upon the value of Young's modulus. If more is the Young's modulus, is nothing but the material is the more elastic. For example, in our daily life, we have rubber and steel. We feel that rubber is more elastic than steel. It is a common thing we feel in our daily life. But rubber is not more elastic compared to the steel. Steel is more elastic than rubber because the elasticity is depend upon the value of Young's modulus. We can understand like this here. How does a steel is more elastic than rubber? Now, we know the formula for Young's modulus. Y is equal to F by A by E by L means L by E. Now, for the same load applied for a steel wire and a rubber cord. Now, this is a steel wire and this is a rubber cord. For both of them, we apply the same force. For the same load applied for both of them, in which more elongation is produced? More elongation produced in a rubber and less elongation produced in steel. If less is the elongation, here Young's modulus is less. Here more is elongation for rubber. If more is elongation and less is the Young's modulus. If less is the Young's modulus, elasticity is less. If more is the Young's modulus, elasticity is more. Now for same load applied for steel and rubber wires and elasticity less for steel, more is the Young's modulus, Young's modulus is more. And for rubber cord, elongation is more, Young's modulus is less. Young's modulus is less nothing but elasticity is less. And also, if we observe the steel and rubber rods, the rubber cord can withstand up to a less load only, but the steel wire can withstand up to a maximum load compared to the rubber cord. Means steel is more elastic than rubber. Now, these are the few applications of the elastic behavior of materials which we apply in our daily life.